If m is greater than n, then this will go to 0. And if this is n and this is m, then it will be non-zero. So as we have assumed here that m is greater than n, then it means that a minus m operating on psi n, this will also be equal to 0. We can do the reverse of it as well. By taking n greater than m, then we will have to change here with a minus first and a plus here. So this means that this thing will be equal. When this will operate, then this will be equal to 0 if m is not equal to n. So for m greater than n, this one will go to 0. And for m less than n, this will be non-zero. So we will have that when m will not be equal to n, we will have this thing equal to 0. And as they are normalized, we are having this thing equal to 1. For this sub m not equal to n, we are having 0. And this gives us the result that psi m and psi n are not only normalized, but they are orthogonal as well. So orthogonal plus normalized, orthogonal plus normalized will give orthonormal. So we are having the condition of orthonormality.
So as a summary, I can briefly discuss this thing, that we want to check the orthonormality condition of the states of the harmonic oscillator. Now the orthonormality condition is that if two states are multiplied, if their indices are the same, then they are normalized wave functions, so we will get 1. What will happen if the indices will not be the same? When the two states will not be the same, then we consider that this is the list of the states and n and m are two indices we have taken from them, such that m is greater than n. Now when we do multiply them, we are having this situation, and I can move this one here and it is like this. So a plus is operating on psi naught. Now when a plus operates on psi naught, then this n may be any number. So for n equal to 1, we will have this psi 1, then 2 will make this psi 2 and so on, and an will make this one a psi n. Now m is an operator which is reducing it. So a minus on psi naught will give 0, because this psi naught is the ground state. Any other power, higher power, will definitely make this thing equal to 0. Now consider psi n. Psi n is a state, is a number. It may be, let's say, 10. Now m, when m is 1, it's operate, it will make it 9. Then again it operates and then it will be reducing. But if m will be greater than n, then a minus operating on this will give us 0, because the ground state will reach, and again this will operate on a ground state and it will lower it and it will give us 0. So the orthonormality condition is equal to 0 for m not equal to n. So when the two indices will not be the same, we will have 0 here. We can prove its reverse as well by taking that n is greater than m, they are just indices, so we can just flip them, and then we will have to apply a minus on this one and n minus, and when a minus will come in here, it will become a plus, and then we will apply such condition on it that n is greater than m, and again we will have 0 here. So this way we can prove the orthonormality condition. Now we can solve example 2.5. And example 2.5 is that find the potential energy or the expectation value of the potential energy in the nth state of the harmonic oscillator. So I know that I have taken is half kx square, and this we convert it into half m omega square x square. So now we will have to convert this thing. If I write this is the expectation value of V, then here I will write half m omega square in the expectation value of x square. Now I know the operators, and the operators are, I will now write this x square in terms of a plus and a minus in order to easily calculate the expectation value of x square. So a plus a minus are actually equal to 1 over 2 m h bar omega, and minus plus ip plus m omega x. Now if I add the two, like a plus is here and I just add the two here, then I will get, for example, this implies, what about a plus if it is added with a minus? So this one will be common, and we will have 1 over 2m h bar omega. This one is common, and here we will have minus ip plus m omega x, and plus then this one means the minus earlier, the a plus, and then plus a minus, so it will be ip and plus m omega x. This is equal to 1 over 2 m h bar omega square root, and the ip is cancelling with the ip, and this is 2 m omega x. So I can simplify the 2 m omega with this one. 2 m omega is gone with 2 m omega, so we are left only with only 1 over h bar here. So this is 2 m omega square root and h bar inside this square root and x out of the square root. So this implies that x is equal to h bar over m 2 m omega square root and a plus a minus. So we have derived the value of x. Now we would like to find the value of x square. So x square will be equal, when this will be squared, then we will have h bar over 2 m omega, and this one a plus a minus, and again a plus a minus. So this will be equal, x square will be equal to h bar over 2 m omega, and this will be a plus squared, plus a plus a minus plus a minus a plus, we will have to keep the order the same, and plus a minus squared. This is our x square value. Now we would like to calculate x square. So x squared and half m omega square. So this will also be with this. We can later on multiply this, but first we would like to calculate this x square, or let me do it that v is equal to half m omega square x square, and this is equal to the nth state. So I will write the nth state, so I can write that half m omega square, and then x square, so this is h bar over 2m omega, and then from minus infinity to plus infinity, and psi n, because this is the nth state, so I will write psi n conjugate and x square psi n dx. Now for x square, I will have to write this v is then equal to m omega is gone with m omega, so I left with only h bar over 4, and then integral from minus infinity to plus infinity, and psi n conjugate, and then for x square average, I can write back this value, which is actually a plus a minus, a plus a minus. So this is a plus square plus a minus plus a minus a plus a minus squared, and here will be psi n dx. Now I know one thing, that when a plus square will operate on psi n, a plus square operates on psi n, it will give psi n minus 2. And when a minus square operates on this, so it will give psi n plus 2. And when a minus square psi n, it is operated on psi n, it will approximately, means neglecting the normalization constant, psi n minus 2. Now when psi n plus 2 and psi n minus 2 will multiply with psi n, then we know the orthonormality condition, that when m and n will not be the same, then we will have 0 here. So for this term and this term, we will get 0. We are only left with a plus a minus and a minus a plus. Now we know that when from the a plus a minus on psi n, we know that when this one operates on psi n, a minus operates on psi n, it gives n, and when a plus operates on psi n, it gives n plus 1. This we have already done, so it will give n in n plus 1, and psi n multiplied with this. So this will be equal that v is equal to h bar 1 over 4 h bar omega, and n plus 1 will be 2n plus 1, and psi mod square, psi n mod square will be equal to 1. So v is equal to
V is equal to half 1 over 4 h bar omega. If I take 2 is common, then 2 will come here and it will simplify with this. So it will be half h bar omega. It is half h bar omega, and this will become n plus half. So this is equal V, and I can write half and then n plus half h bar omega. Now I know this one from earlier, that this is E, so V comes out to be half E. So the potential, the expectation value of potential energy comes out to be exactly half the total energy. So the total energy means the half is the potential energy, while if I find the P square value and then divide by 2m, then I will get, like, if I find this one, you can do it as an exercise, that write now like this, that here x I have found in terms of a plus a minus. Now what you do, you just subtract a plus minus a minus, and these two terms will survive and these two will cancel, and you will find p in terms of a plus minus a minus, and then apply it on the psi n, and we will get that t is also equal to half the total energy, and this will write the conservation equation, the total energy plus V. So half the kinetic energy and half the potential energy makes the total energy. This way the law of conservation of energy is held here.